China's efforts to boost its economy have been making headlines recently, but the market reaction has been somewhat underwhelming. So, could there be more stimulus ahead for the world's second largest economy? Joining me now to discuss is Haining Zha, VP and Director for Asset Allocation Research at TD Asset Management. Haining, great to have you back on the program.
Thanks for having me.
All right, so it's a great time to have you on because Chinese stimulus has been in the headlines for several weeks now. Where are we at right now?
So basically, the September 24th is the turning point. So before September 24th, there were certainly supportive policies, but I would say the support is kind of isolated, uncoordinated, and you know didn't have the endorsement from the highest policy circle. After September 24th, everything has changed. So you got government officials from central bank, from Ministry of Finance, from securities regulators, and from NDRC, you know, the National Reform and Regulatory Commissions, all coming out with supportive narratives. And we also have, you know, the Politburo meeting really set the tone of the policy. So if we, you know, classify all of the supporting policy into different areas, there are basically first monetary policy. You have central bank cutting rates, providing more liquidity. And there are second areas of area, which is the housing related policy. You have lowering initial down payment, lowering mortgage rates, removing any of the purchasing restrictions. And the third area is aimed directly at the stock market. You have central banks setting up two innovative schemes. One is the swap facility to provide liquidity, and the other one is the corporate buyback facility. And the fourth area would be the fiscal policy. On that, the details are not finalized yet, and we will be hearing it very soon in early November.
All right, so we got a lot to get through there. When you talked about the different parts of coordinated policy, you talked about trying to support the stock market. Is it fair to characterize the reaction in the markets as a bit underwhelming to what's happened so far?
Well, it is kind of complicated by the Golden Week holiday. So actually, before the Golden Week holiday, after the announcement of these stimulus measures, the momentum was quite strong. But what happened is when the market is shut for the whole week, when the external market keep rallying, and when it come in, you know, in the Chinese market, there is only for retail investor, the T plus zero trading is not allowed. I.e., if you put in a buy order today and the transaction got executed, you cannot get out of the market right away. So what happens is when the market reopens, all of the people putting on the limit up order, and then when the negative news flow coming, they all got hit. When they got fulfilled, executed, they cannot timely get out of the market. And there is a little bit of a sentiment or emotional overrun as well. So that would be a slightly negative. And also the US election remain overhang for the Chinese equity market. But I think for the medium term, if China can really execute on some of these stimulus measures, and also pending on fiscal stimulus measures, when the broader macroeconomic number changes and when we see earning recovery, that will kick off the second phase of the rally, probably.
All right, let's talk about that pending fiscal stimulus. There are reports out there as to what it might look like and the fact that you said it's being finalized. What's your take on it? What do you think they are planning?
Yeah, so the expectations are all over the place. Some people are expecting $2 trillion additional stimulus. Some people say four, and there are some even numbers say $10 trillion divided across multiple years. But I would say the market attention on one specific number might be justified, but we think this time around it's more important to focus on that policy tone. So this time around, the Chinese government really has that whatever it takes mentality. So we think it is slightly misleading to just focus on one number, because if that number, you know, underwhelmed and undershoot people's expectation, they will just simply add on more. So really, that determination to, you know, kick off the Chinese economy out of this vicious deflation cycle is more important.
When you talk about the government being willing to do whatever it takes, what is it going to take? If we're talking about a deflationary environment, trying to get out of what you call the vicious cycle, what does Beijing have to put on the table to start changing this economic story?
I would say it's a little bit everything. As I mentioned, for those four areas, they definitely need to continue doing it. Sometimes people just need to see that the actual economic number improves so that they can gain more confidence. And once they gain more confidence, all of a sudden the company is willing to recruit more people, and then you kick off a virtuous cycle. But they could certainly do more. For example, on the fiscal policy front, they can, you know, targeting a number a little bit more than what market expected. And also in terms of those innovative scheme, for example, there are talks that they are considering establishing a stabilization fund. The initial size could be 2 trillion RMB. They could upsize that. And also they could essentially direct the central bank to provide some of the swap facility, liquidity facility for the new stabilization fund. That would be the big bazooka the market is expecting.
When we do get these fiscal measures, is it important? I mean, obviously the lens through which we're viewing this through is like, what will the impact be on the economy and on the markets? Because obviously we're a show about investing. Is it important though to pull back sometimes and realize the market reaction on day one, day two, and day three does not cement the success or the failure of these plans? Do we need a longer term picture of all this?
Right. So I would say initially, in the short run, it is really an expectation game, whether you beat market expectation or not. But at a certain point, the true effect of the policy and their aggregated size is much more important. Just like when we think about looking back and look at the global financial crisis, initially people thought, oh, whatever the central bank or US government did is probably not enough. Until there is a turning point and people sense that the market sentiment is turning, and later on they see the real changes in the economy, then you kind of kick off that virtuous cycle.
All right, so when we do get this fiscal stimulus, what are you really going to be looking for? What's the first detail you're going to be jumping in and trying to take a look at?
First, as you mentioned, first of all, it's the size and also the use of that money. So there are talks that some part of the money will be used for local government debt swap so that the local government stop bleeding, they can pay the government staff as well as so for various uses. And also there is talking about the supporting measure for the consumption. And also the infrastructure is an integral part of the picture. So you have to essentially spending money on all these front to kick off the aggregate demand.